Hello, everybody. Welcome to Watercolor Wednesday. This is just fun and playful watercolors. That's what we're doing each week here at the Kraaft Shaak. So, last time we were together, I had made some warm-ups, and this was the first one that I had done with the M-Gram turquoise and the nickel quinacridone gold, and just made a warm-up. And when it was dry, I really felt like it reminded me of the ocean. It looks like the beach, and the water is sort of receding from the sand's edge there. And so I was inspired to do a seashell. I have sketched in, and I'm not sure you're going to be able to see the lines at all. They're very, very light. A large conch shell on the front. So this is what I do with my warm-ups. I've got my Daniel Smith palette here that I'm going to be using. Okay, so I'm going to be using an 8-inch round, at least to start with. This is my Soho Urban Artist. I got this at Jerry's. Great deal. And let me make sure that I've got the picture that I'm using as a reference. Just something that I found in Creative Commons images. All right, and let's just start with, I'm just going to start with the pinkish color that I see here on this. So this is opera pink, and then I'm going to add to that just a little bit of this new gamboge. So it's going to give me kind of more of an orangey, pinky orangey. And actually, let's add Quin Pink, which is right next to it, just to give it a little bit more pink. There we go. So it's a little bit orangey, a little bit pinky, a little bit more water. And we're just going to put a wash down where the line is. So even though you can't see probably my pencil marks, you'll be able to at least see as I put in right up against this line here, which is the fold of the conch going down. You can see that, right? A little bit more water. Do it again. And it's sort of, oop, not enough water on my brush. See that, how it's split like that? All right, I'm going to turn it so it's a little easier for me to grab it. And then this is just water on the brush, a lot of water. Almost too much water, but I'm just going to drag out that edge to the end of the conch here. Not the whole thing, just so it sort of fades off there. All right, and down here, put a little bit more of that color on the tip of my brush. I think I want too much color, but down here it a little bit more color dropped in here, so it'll really have some depth in that where it sort of falls down into it. Okay, so down here on the corner and going up, it's sort of wavy, so I want you to be able to see that. Right in here, it's wavy. We're going to define those later as it dries a little bit, but okay, I like that. That's pretty good. All right, so now over on this side, there's also pink coming towards us and sort of fading as it comes around, but we're not going to mess with that because this is still wet. So let's let that dry. And while we're letting that dry, we're going to go into the new gamboge. That kind of a darker yellow, tad bit of that orange, pyrrole orange. And we'll just grab a little bit of that pink color that we made, that pinky coral color that we made. And we're going to go in here and define the shape over here. So as I paint, my image will sort of come to life for you, I hope. I hope. So it's really dark in here because It's shadow for one thing, but two, because it's got some hard edges. It's a shell, by the way. It's protecting just a wet brush, clean water, wet brush, dry off a little bit so we don't have too much water. It's got to protect the animal inside, right? All right, so I'm going to soften these edges just a little bit. So we don't have such a harsh line. And I'm leaving that white. You see that? Let me see if you can see that. Do you see that white that was left there from when we painted the background? That was just an accident. We're going to utilize that in the painting. It's partly why I chose to put it where I did, put the drawing where I did. All right, here's where the shape of the conch shell is going to take place. It's really the darkest part of this shell is right here. I'm just gonna concentrate. Let's put a little bit of that coral in. Just get a little darker. And again, soften some of these edges. Just let them sort of drift out towards the rest of the shell. Okay, now there is sort of a jagged edge here that we're going to create with this brush tip. But it's not this color. So really what I'm doing is I'm adding some shadow to the edge of what is the points and texture of the shell itself. That's what I'm doing. Put some more color in here. You know, that's going to dry. It's going to be a little bit less prominent. Just putting some in where the shadow is over there. And there's a teensy bit of this up in here too. We're going to put that in there as well, right where this curve is. That's going to be good. So we'll let that dry teensy bit down in here where some of those spiky points are. Okay, so hopefully this shell is starting to come to life. I may actually put the sketch to this available on the blog post that I associate with this for anybody to use. So that's dry enough. Okay, so let's go back into that coral that I made. I'm going to actually just add a little bit more of that quinacridone pink rose. Sorry, quinac. Is it quin pink? Yes, it is quin pink. Daniel Smith colors here. And I'm going to go right along that edge where, actually, now that I'm looking at the picture, the darker is on the inside of the fold. So let's just do that. Yeah, since I've made it darker, let's just go darker into here, right there in that fold. But it doesn't go all the way down. It's just like right there. And I'm going to drag it out because it really fades towards the edge. Really fades. All right, so that gives that receding, going back off into the distance. And again, I got to let that edge dry. So let's go into some purple. All right, what are we going to use? I think I'm going to use that quin pink because I'm going to stick with those same colors. And let's use like a turquoise. Just see what kind of purple we get. Oh yeah. Yeah. Oh, you didn't see any of that. Well, you're welcome. All right, so I used the quin pink here and then this phthalo turquoise. I just touched it and created this purple over here, which is great. But now I'm going to add water to it because it's a little too strong. Got a good wash over there. And then I'm going to go into some of these spots where there's a shadow right here. A little too strong. A little too strong. So I'm going to just use some water, dab that out, and a lot more water. All on that color. So the pigment's just too strong for the type of shadow that I want to put in here. So I'm just really, really adding a lot of water. So it's less pigment, more water. It's going to give it a softer. There we go. So now what I want to do is create those jagged edges by putting a shadow underneath where the jagged parts are. All right, and then there's a bit of shadow inside here, right inside where that lip is. And it sort of comes down towards the pink coral color. Doesn't need to be so sharp right here, so we're just going to go in with some water. Just blend that out. And it sort of fades right here as well. Isn't that pretty? Look at how that's creating a really nice, very soft shadow. We're going to work that shadow all the way around though. So I'm going to turn it just so we can get a better angle. And that shadow is going to come down and around and be pretty dark right in here. See how we have that white? That's just a part of the image that we created before. So we're going to just utilize that. Even though this isn't what's in my photo, I'm going to use that. It looks like it's a highlight. Let's use it. All right, just taking more water and bringing out that edge. Just want it to be a little softer. All right, hopefully you're able to see this. It's real subtle, but it's there. All right, going back to the tips and the points, let's add some. It's a little bit in here, a little bit in here. Got a nice point right here. And quite a bit more here. So we're going to go right over the top of that orangey that we put in. That's going to make that a much darker spot. And we're going to accentuate that point a little bit further. All right, and using the shadow color, I'm going to define the edge of where the front of this conch shell is. Pushing the pointed spiked area back further. Utilizing that highlight that's naturally there. I'm going to create some more shadow here. Just picking up more of that pigment so it's a little bit more prominent here. And let's just go right over the top of this part right here. Pushing this down further, even further, even further back. Now it's getting some roundedness to it because it's going away from us now. I'm going to lay in some striped. These kind of go horizontal to what I'm painting. They sort of go down towards the point without it going. All being angled at the point. So they're kind of big and then they get really small. We're going to do a couple of those. You see how it's going towards the point, but not at an angle until it gets to about here. Add some more shadow in here. A little bit there. All right, it's starting to look like a conch shell, I think. I think it is. Boy, I hope you can see it. All right, let's go in with some of the shadow on these. Remember I told you there's some wavy points here? Well, now I'm going to show you that there's wavy points. A little bit of wavy there. Okay, and just to accentuate, we're going to add, well, I was going to add that, but I really would like to add the coral to the top of this so we can get some. All right, watering down that darker color that I gave a little bit too much, I'm going to actually add, no, I'm not. I'm just going to add the water to it and leave it at that. I'm going to go around like this. I really should wait till that shadow is definitely dry, but we'll just avoid it carefully as we pull out the color there. Just a little hush of color and go right over the top of that highlight that we've got there, and the white underneath will still act like a highlight because this is so transparent. All right, can you see all that going on there? Need just a little bit more. I like to pretend I know what I'm doing anyway. Need just a little bit more dropped right into here. So this is color dropping right into there. Just mixing a little bit more color to be able to drop in. That's going to be too intense. It's not bad if you're subtle with it. If you're subtle with it. Okay, so like I'm saying, subtle with it, but I'm not. All right. A drier brush. It's clean, but I've gotten rid of the excess moisture, and now I'm just going to go in here and sort of dictate where that goes. So just lightly brushing it into these areas here. So by not introducing any more water, I'm not actually going to make it bloom or dissipate at all. It's just going to remain pigmented the way that I want it to be. Okay, that edge looks too perfect. I don't like that. So we're going to go in here now with a wet brush and pick up some of that color. So I'm brushing towards the colored area. Kind of going over that shadow a little bit, which I don't want to do. So just avoid that. The shadow area is still wet. That's why I'm going to avoid it. And it's okay if it touches now because that's going to add to the shadow area. So let's just let that dry. Right now it's starting to look like, almost looks like a taco, but the idea is it's supposed to be a conch shell. So let's go back up into here's dry. Okay. I have my, I'm going to add some Quinn pink to this because it's starting to look a little too orange. Really want that coral look to it. Okay, so going up here to define this edge, I'm going underneath and I'm going to just draw with the tip of my brush where that conch ends as it rolls forward. It has kind of a lip. And then with a clean brush, wiped off on the paper towel so it's not dripping at all, I'm going to soften that edge. Okay, we're going to do that all the way down. Let's just take it all the way down to this ruffle right there, where it starts to ruffle. Okay, and now with the background color, which I think I'm going to go into this phthalo turquoise and make myself a wash of this phthalo turquoise over here. Just add some water. It's got a little bit of carbazole violet as well. There's just a teensy bit on the tray there. It's fine. We're going to go back in here and define the other edge. So this is the back side of the shell. And I'm going to start in the more intense area and drag out like I did with the inside. So this is going out to the outside edge. And I'm going just above my pencil line. You really can't see my pencil lines anymore, but I know where it is because I stopped with the paint. And I'm going just above it, and the reason why I'm going just above it is because it's going to leave that little highlighted area, or it'll appear to be a highlighted area. Again, clean brush, dabbed off on my paper towel so it's not dripping, and then go in here and just soften that edge away from the shell. A little bit more. It's not quite pulling away as much as I would like it to. And then with what's left, I'm just taking it down to the ruffle like I did on the inside. So now you can see it just sort of popped off, right? All right, we're going to do that for the whole thing. And the only other thing I want to use is a little bit more of that purple mixture that I made, but I want it to be a little bit more vibrant. So we're going to go back into that Quin Pink, just dabbed it, add some there, rinse my brush, go back into, this is just one dab, make that purple again, just a little bit more intense. And from here, I'm going to do the same thing that I did for the inside of that roll, but I'm going to do it for these shadows. Just to find right where that lights the least, right? And by, I don't want to say outlining, but by adding some of these defined marks on this side where the light is least. Maybe I can zoom in for that. Where these lights, where the light is hitting this the least, I'm putting the most purple. And then you're going to be able to see those lines, which are the shell. So. Just outlining those edges. It's really hard to do these details and talk at the same time, so forgive me as I go a little quiet. And I don't like adding music to these parts because you may be somebody who doesn't really like the music too much. I'm one of those people. I don't really like the music too much, but especially sometimes when it's too loud, that's when I really get frustrated because a lot of times I have my earbuds in and I'm trying to listen closely to what the person is saying, and then all of a sudden music takes over. All right, anywhere that there's a line that needs to be defined so that you can see what the image is, I'm putting that there with this darker purple just to suggest where the line is, just to suggest where it sort of juts out away from the rest of it. A lot of this is suggestion. Your brain is going to fill in the rest of it. So I didn't, let's see, I want to try to not turn it because I know that'll mess with the camera view, but it's a little bit shadow there. I need to fix that, but. Fix that. By fix that, I mean soften the edges a little bit. But first, I want to add this darker into these folds. Notice I'm not painting the whole fold. I'm just dropping it into the center where it's darkest. So going back with just water and a very not really wet brush, I can fix that there. All right, so again with my outer color, I can go in here and really define where this curve is because You can see back to the, this is a part of the background right here, and you didn't even know that until I just did that there for you. Now this turquoise that I'm using is not the same turquoise that we used when we made the background, but it's okay. They work well together. Daniel Smith and M. Graham colors are good together. They're very good together. All right, let's go back in with some more of that coral. And I'm going to define a little bit of a shape here. Just these natural, I didn't mean to clean that brush off, just sort of habit. Just these natural indentations and marks that take place right along the edge here. A little bit more depth to where this fold is. Right, we're gonna just clean brush, a little damp, it's not wet, a little damp, and just sort of drag that out. And let it be a little fragmented, let it be a little, have a little bit of energy there. It's okay. There we go. I'm liking that. All right, so let's go right back into this turquoise again, and I'm going to pick up right along this edge, right where those points are. Notice I'm not actually touching the image itself. Am I on camera? There we go. I'm not touching the image itself. I'm sort of outlining beyond where the shadows are because there's those highlights, okay? And again, wet brush tapped off on the paper towel. The idea is to have some fun with this. It doesn't have to be perfect. Remember, you're just suggesting that this is a shell. And we're just going to do the same thing right up here. And this is not going to be drug out as much. I'm going to put in a lot more dark here because this is a part of that background. That would be negative painting we did just there. Just going in and painting around the subject, leaving it, leaving what was already on the paper as the image. Just really wet brush here just to soften those edges and really make it part of that already there color. Sort of spread it out. That's good. All right, you see that seashell coming to life? This is really nice because I've had such a hard time with the winter. I know a lot of my friends are experiencing some winter issues where they live, and they live in the south, and that's just not cool, man. Not cool. All right, let's just add just a little bit of dimension here. Notice how it looks like the light, there's a light, like a beam of light going across the piece. That's really cool. Just adding some shadow, making it look much more jagged, much more, well, much more like a shell, really. All right, we are just about finished with this guy. He's cool. All right, so the only thing left to do is to find this, define this edge over here, and by doing that, I'm going to go into the new gamboge. And just a touch, yeah, you can't see it again. New gamboge, let's do that again. New gamboge right here. I'm just going to make myself a wash over here. And we're just going to touch this Quinn burnt orange. So I just touched it with the tip of the brush. We're just going to add that to it. It's going to give us a little darker darker orangey, whatever. I could use the same color, but this is more fun, and it's right here. So we're just gonna do the same thing we did on the other side. And actually, let's add a little bit more of the Quinn burnt orange to make it a little bit darker, because it's sort of the same color-ish over here. And I want there to be some more contrast in there. So we'll just drop that in, giving us the shape of that conch shell right there. And again, just clean off the brush, tap it on the paper towel, and we're going to just pull out the edge. And let's not leave any highlights down here. Let's actually take this all the way over. We don't want any highlights there. And we'll let it fade out really well over here. So we're just going to wet brush, clean this edge up here. Wet brush.
Grab your paintbrushes, it's time to play. It's Watercolor Wednesday. Get the paper and we'll have some fun. Everybody can join. We'll have some fun together. We'll learn things together. It'll be a great time at the Kraaft Shaak. Join us. It's time to play. It's Watercolor Wednesday. Join us. It's time to play Watercolor Wednesday.